Next question says, a heavy uniform chain lies on a horizontal tabletop. If the coefficient of friction between the chain and the table surface is 0.25, then the maximum fraction of the length of the chain that can hang over one edge of the table. So what we need to understand is that there is a table on which some part of the chain is lying and some part is hanging over the edge of the table. So if I assume the part which is hanging as x and the part which is on top becomes the total length minus x, so it is L minus x. Now there is a term called as linear mass density. We can denote it by lambda, and that's m by l, mass per unit length. So I can say the mass which is hanging will be x times the linear mass density, and the mass which is on the top is l minus x times the linear density. So this over here, the mass hanging, as I said, is going to be lambda x. And the mass on top of the table, obviously, that's lambda L minus x. So this diagram can be replaced like this, that there is a block which has a mass lambda L minus x attached with a wire and a pulley. The wire pulley is frictionless and the wire is weightless. So there is a mass hanging which is of lambda x. Now if we see this, this becomes a very normal sum which can be solved by using free body diagram. So if I draw free body diagram of this body, we get this as lambda xg, and the balancing force will be the tension. So from this we can say tension is lambda xg, whereas the free body diagram for this would be, the weight will be lambda bracket L minus x g, there will be a normal reaction, there will be tension, and the friction force will be the one which is going to balance the tension. So here I can say tension is equal to friction, and friction we know is mu n, and n we know it is lambda L minus x g. So if we understand the tension is this and the tension is this, so we can equate this two, and therefore we get lambda xg is mu times lambda L minus xg. So lambda and g gets cancelled. The value of mu is 0.25, that's equivalent to 1 by 4. So 4 goes over here, becomes 4x is equal to L minus x. That gives you 5x equal to L, and therefore I can say x is L by 5. Since we want the answer in percentage, I would multiply this by 100, which gives me 20% of L, and that becomes the final answer.